Hello everyone, how are you all? So let's start our video and we will learn about reports today. Reports, process reports and various other forms of reports and how we can use the process reports and how to create one. So let's start our video. And so what we need to do to create a report, like there are two types of report, process report and report. So let's see how to create a report object. We just need to give the name and add an interface. Inside the interface, we can add any interface which consists of pie charts, columns, read-only grids, waterfall graphs, and any other API components which shows reports. So why we are creating this object, basically we need to add this inside our site to show all the reports. So there we cannot directly add interface, we can use this report object to use this as a report. So I've just selected an interface and I'll create one. And we can use this report object anywhere where we want to add the reports. So process report is quite different from this report. For process report, we need to create this object, process report object, and let's do it from scratch. TA process report. And we can give the description. So the main thing inside this object is three types: process model type, process type, and task type. So we have options, like if we select process model, then we can have all process model. Okay, we can select this one, process model created by a user. So I can select a user in which the process, like I have created, for example, I've created a process model. So I only want the report of that process model which is created by me. So I'll choose this option. And the third is model last modified by. So it is just the same as the second one. It is just picking up the models which is last modified by the particular user. We can select the user. So similarly, we have processes, like all processes, process initiated by user, processes by process model. So in this processes means the instances of process. And the third one is task. Task is like it is the different thing, like if we assign anyone any task. So this is like they are talking about that task where we assign some task to someone. So we have options like all task, task attribute to a user. Like if I select the second one, then I will select a particular user, then all the task which got assigned to that particular user will come under this category. So the third is task assigned to a group. We can select the group, we can select the owner, we can select the process model and task by processes. So let me choose this one, task by process model. So what will happen, all the task, whatever the task is in the process model, will come under this report. And I'll use this saving. TA process report. I have already created a folder before. So this is the folder and this is the process report which we have selected. Okay, let's select another one because this one I have already created it. Let's select this one, task by owner or assigned to a particular user. Let's select this one. So I just need to hit the create button. So this TA process report is created. Likewise, we have also created this one, TA task detailed report. So let me open this one first and also the one which we have created just right now. So this is the report which we have created right now. And this is the task report. And inside this name, this is the report panel, right? And we have name, status, processes, and start time. So these are the task name, the processes. If I'll go to the configuration, so these are the processes name, and these are the name is the task name. So like if I create on and click on this one name, then this is tp dot tp bank name. Like we are whenever we wanted to fetch something related to a particular task, then we need to use tp bank, and formatting is normal text, and this is the configuration of this name, like the task name. Let me cancel it and status. This is status is fetching up the status, like the definition is task status, like whatever the status will be, like it is assigned, it is accepted, all the status will come here by using this function task status. And the process, this is a pp name, like process name, process model name. And the last one is started time. So this is tp start time, like tp bank start time. Whenever the task got assigned to a user, then it got started. So this is that start time. So we have four by default, like they have given us this four columns. We can add more, and let me add one more, and I'll name it tp id, or just id, task id. And the definition is, what we will do, we will take the tp bank id. So whenever the task got assigned, or whenever a task is created, then a particular id, system generated assigned id, is there for this reference of the task. So task id is a unique id. Okay, I can just save and close it, and formatting is number, just hit the save button and save. So the new column is coming right now, task id. So these all are the task id. Let me save this report again. So now our report is ready. I've also created another report similar to that, just this reports is like initiated by a particular user, like it is showing Akshay Sharma, and this report is like this task, like a process model, like this is the process model name coming, like we have created this report and choose that option, like task and the process model for a particular process model. So this is the particular process model, TRE assign notify test, and whatever the task inside this process model will comes under this report. So what we can do now, I'll show you how to use this report. So like we can just directly create a report and use it with any of the process model by using the contest, which is process model IDs. Let me show you this one, this rule. Okay, so in this rule I have used this report. So for using a report, we need to use Appian query process analytics, and we need to pass that report. So I have created a constant TA task report reassign for this report, for this one, and I have passed the constant inside this process function. So the report is there, and the contest process models. So I have also created a constant which refers to the process model. So this is the process model. I have created a constant for this one, and I have used inside the ABank query process analytics. And what we are fetching from, I have put the index function and fetching the data. So whenever I pass any identifier, the identifier in this case is process model ID. Let me show you the report. So in this report, I have added the identifier, this one, process ID. So I'm fetching the process ID, and I'm fetching the particular report data for that process model ID. So let me pass some process model ID 81, and we will test this one, the rule which I have created. I'm passing this 81. This is the place where we can test the data. So the data is coming. I'm fetching this data directly, only the email ID, the list of user. So the now the list of user is my email ID and my name. Index, I mean only fetching the user details. Okay, so the reports part is complete. So this is our rule, which is fetching the data, the list of users by using the identifier as process model ID by this report, TA task detail for this particular process model. And what I have done, I have also created a process model where I am using this process report to fetching the data. So I have created a script task, and inside the output tab, I've used this rule and passed the parameter identifier, because I want some functionality where I need to fetch the data of the list of users. So I've implemented likewise. This is how we use process reports, and the process report is really very useful when we want some data, some process data, some task data. So this is all about process reports. Thank you so much. We'll see you in next video.